Alright, Guido, I know how much you hate socializing, okay? I know it's a big deal for you. You hate going to any kind of get together, but I found someone today that I really think you'd like. Yep, his name is Death. I met him at the park. He was walking his dog, I was riding my bike. It seemed like fate. Anyway, Mr. Death here is really. No, Guido. Guido, Mr. Death isn't evil. Why would you say that? Is it his giant devil-like wings? The chains around his lower half? His giant scythe? His lack of any discernible features? Guido, you can't judge a book by its cover. Yeah, I guess with a name like Death, it is rather suspicious. Say, give me a second here. Look, between you and I, are you evil? That's not the case, right? You're not- Oh. Okay, well, Guido, it looks like we've got a little bit of an issue on our hands. It turns out that Death is evil. I know, who'd have thought it? And he seems to have this giant death mist surrounding him. I don't know if you can see this, but you can see this giant plume of smirk, which means whenever he is near anything, everything is obscured. As you can see right here, I'm not sure what exactly this mist is made up of, but... Oh, gosh. Whatever it is definitely... Definitely not good for you. Oh, jeez, I'm gonna be sick. Man, it is a good thing that Death didn't invite his friends over to this battlefield. Who is that? Oh my gosh. So this is Hades, and this is the World Serpent. Basically three of the most evil and destructive mythical creatures known to man. And they've... Okay, two of the most formidable and evil creatures in the entire multiverse. So I guess it's up to us to defeat Death, Hades, and the undead army. Man, I was really, really surprised that Death turned out to be evil. I guess I'm cursed not to have any friends at all, ever. Perfect. What a great life to lead. So let's start off with the main man himself, Big Daddy D. D-Dog, Death. Let's start with Death. Death is, as we all know, coming for each and every one of us, but not today, Guido. We shall be fighting him with this guy. Look, don't be afraid, dude. It's only Death. All you have to do is charge in there and fight him and, you know, secure the day, secure the victory. We'll get you home and, well, Guido, I've got to put him against someone pretty basic just so we can see the abilities of Death and what exactly we're working with here. This guy is, as long as he doesn't hear us, I can say this, a bit of a test dummy. And we are off. The science experiment begins now. Death is strutting his stuff towards the squire here and, oh my gosh, he missed. Oh my gosh, come on, dude. You can defeat Death. Death is doing nothing. He's just staring at... Okay, I take that back. Death definitely did something. He straight up decapitated that poor man. I'll give him some backup. This time I've given him a very small army of his comrades. We have some archers, we have the three squires, and that quite short one in the center there. I think he's like a teenager who's on his first day of work experience. And we have this knight who is leading the charge. So this small team, again, are gonna be taking on Death himself. And we're off, Guido. Have you got any predictions for... What? What? They just iced Death straight away, what the heck? I don't understand, is that all it took? Some archers to just plink at him and eventually take him down? Oh my gosh, he got an arrow right to the crotch. Maybe that's Death's weakness? Let's try this one again, maybe it was a fluke. Go Death, go, let's see it happen. So he's, oh my gosh. All it takes is a couple of archer shots and that's literally Death done? Okay, I've got to try this. One archer. Here comes the arrow. It has been launched from the bow and, okay, Death actually managed to deflect that one. In your own time, it's okay. You know, nothing to be nervous about. It's only Death approaching. And, are you gonna do... Okay, fine. So it turns out that one archer can't defeat Death. This time, I will possess one of the archers and try fight Death myself. Okay, let's just aim... oh, he's coming right for me. Okay, I'm gonna back up here and fire. There we go, got a shot in the back there. Oh, it looks like that guy distracted him for a bit. Oh gosh, he's so fast, this is terrifying. Ah, no, No, how did that miss? Okay, we're right on the edge. We're good. Oh, geez, we are not good. Okay, so that experiment was very weird. Occasionally, Death won, and occasionally, the Archers won. Let's just move on. We have more people to take on, including this guy. It's everyone's favorite god of the underworld. My boy Hades, how you doing, man? Welcome to the show. Now, alongside Hades, he's brought his army of the damned. We have some damned blockers, some damned throwers, some damned, I think these are called damned clusters or something like that. I have no idea what's going on. And we also have a damned screecher right at the back who's ready to yell his boots off. Taking those guys on, we have some farmers who, for one, are looking the completely wrong way. Have you seen like a cute bird in the sky or something like that? What's going on? We've also got the wheelbarrower, who, God help them all, and the potion sellers right at the back, who are going to be providing range support. Okay, so we've got literal farmers against an army from the underworld. This is not something I saw myself doing when I woke up this morning. And G.U.I.D.O, we are off! The wheelbarrower is moving in, throwing an apple at Hades' head, who deflects it, and here come the Persians. G.U.I.D.O, what do you think about this battle? Oh my gosh, look at that! Did you just catch that? Sorry to interrupt you there, but Hades just actually, like, teleported behind the wheelbarrowers for a second, and now they're getting swarmed by the undead, and oh, he did it again. Let's focus on Hades for a little bit here. So he's just slowly taking down these dudes, you know, using his teleportation to get the flank and pinch behind them. Okay, I'm pretty sure he's gonna be able to defeat these guys at the back pretty quickly, and it looks like some farmers are still up fighting on the main bridge, which is quite impressive considering the amount of the undead that there are, the damned army. We have the screecher here. Oh, he kind of bellows at them and blows them straight over. That's amazing. Hades is just dealing with this potion seller right now. Took him out pretty quickly. We have another potion seller here who is unaware that the literal god of the underworld is moving in on him here. Probably something you want to pay attention to. Oh, we have a damned person right here, right in front of this poor, oh gosh, this poor potion seller who's going to be slain by Hades any second now. This hay bale has been knocked over. It looks like, oh my gosh, Hades just took that guy out. So we have one last hay baler here. Can he do it for his country? Can he defeat the god of the underworld and his underworld army? Probably not, but he has a pretty decent defense here in the form of the hay bale. Is he still alive or? No, there's one more person? Who is, what? Okay, apparently there was one more person there, but I have no idea who or where they were. Okay, well, let's move on. Next, we have the World Serpent, who, right at the start of this adventure, had a very interesting tactic, so we'll have to see if he employs that again. Anyway, we've got the World Serpent. Okay, well, the World Serpent was there. We have him against, okay, yep, I get it, he's dead. And here he is, slowly sinking into the ground. He's very shy. Anyway, contending against the World Serpent, if he does return, we have a small selection of the tribal faction. Now, we do have some mammoths who I expect to make very quick work of the World Serpent here. So, G.U.I.D.O, do you fancy fried snake for dinner tonight? No, I don't know why I said that either. That was a terrible suggestion. And we are off. The World Serpent is moving in. And oh my gosh, he can literally just burn these guys alive? Are you kidding me? Oh, we might be having fried mammoth instead. But the World Serpent is currently being swarmed by the mammoths here. Although they all look a little bit tangled. This could keep them stationary, allowing the World Serpent to easily just burn them to death. And I think right now that strategy is working. The World Serpent is desperately trying to wrap around between the mammoth's legs, but it looks like that fire, which is being kind of contained in the center here, is not going to be good for any mammoths involved, because slowly but surely, they are going to be taken down. It looks like the World Serpent is actually being pinned down by one mammoth right at the back, while the other ones get on the offensive, but as soon as one of these mammoths fall, if they do fall, it will allow the World Serpent to become untangled and take these guys on. Oh my gosh! They did it! The mammoths took down the World Serpent. I am amazed. Well, I've got to see it now. I've got to see how one World Serpent contends against one mammoth. Was it a sheer case of there being too many mammoths, or is the World Serpent just trash? I have no idea. It looks like, oh, the World Serpent kind of folded back in on itself here and is now firing upside down, performing all kinds of trick shots here. Just burning away, getting that toasty, toasty mammoth fur. And, oh, this mammoth is just like trampling this guy. Oh my gosh! The World Serpent has broken his own neck. I do wonder, actually, If the whole reason that the mammoths won that first time, oh my gosh, that first time is because the world serpent actually breathed fire on himself, like several times, that could be it. But looks like the world serpent is now moving in, trying to slowly burn away at these, what? The mammoth didn't do anything. I mean, with a body structure like this, it's no wonder that the serpent died. But still, the mammoth literally did nothing. I'm amazed. Okay, it's time to put Hades, Death, and the Wild Serpent, and the Damned Army all together, and we're gonna see how they contend against one very particular unit I have in mind. It's Thor! Yeah, I wanna see how Thor does against the God of the Underworld, Death, and the World Serpent, who hasn't made his way here yet, because if he stands by himself for 5 minutes, he ends up killing himself, so that's probably not the best idea for, this epic battle. We also have 20 of the undead army factions, so this is gonna be... Oh, this is gonna be a mess. But to be honest with you, Thor, if the World Serpent can die to one mammoth, I'm pretty sure you can take down just one undead underground army. I'm sure. Add in the World Serpent super quickly, and we are off. Here comes Thor. Let's see if he can... Uh-oh. Here comes the World Serpent burning away on Thor. And Thor is being absolutely... Oh my gosh. Thor has been taken down, and the rest of the units are moving in. Come on, Thor. You can do it. I believe... Oh my gosh. He's just been, like, wrapped around and flung somewhere. Oh, this is not looking good. The undead army are moving in. Oh, and he just did a lightning attack. I think that just took down Death. But Hades is... Oh my gosh. Sorry, Thor. I really thought you could do it. Okay, how about 4 Thors and 1 Grakalor? I'm not sure what a Grakalor is, but let's see if the same kind of thing happens here. I kind of feel like... Oh my gosh. What? That was a huge lightning bolt from... I think that was Grakalor that... Oh my gosh. Dude, why didn't I just use Grakalor from the start? He is crazy. I guess he's got the Stormbreaker and the rest of them have Mjolnir or something. Because this guy is fully upgraded and he is managing to... Oh my gosh! Look at that, he just blew away half of the team here. So let's see who's still alive. Death is down, Hades remains, and the World Serpent remains. Oh! The World Serpent is slithering and wrapping his body around Grakalor there, but he just accidentally took down Hades. Oh my gosh, those explosions from Stormbreaker are absolutely crazy. It looks like Thor, one of the original Thors, could be being taken down by Hades here. But Grakalor is managing to get on the flank here, pinch around, and try to take down, well, at least the World Serpent, who he just took down. So now it's 1v1, Grakalor versus Hades. Hades has a broken arm. This has been a brutal battle. Oh my gosh. Oh, it looks like they're both still alive. It's like jousting. They keep running towards each other and... Who won that? Did Thor win? I think Thor literally just murdered... Yes, just murdered Hades. Holy cow. Well, there we have it. Amidst lightning, thunder, and this disgusting smelling mist, Thor managed to take down the World Serpent, Hades, and Death. Again, this is something I did not foresee myself doing this morning, but yeah, exactly, G.U.I.D.O. Life is full of surprises. Well, what an adventure.